Hello students, welcome back to my next lecture on basic maths. In our previous lectures, we have completed two chapters. Now we are starting with the next chapter, that is partial fractions. So remaining two chapters we will do later on. So let's see the next chapter, that is partial fractions. So introduction part will say that any given rational fraction may be expressed in terms of different simple fractions which are called partial fractions. That is, here consider the expression 3 upon x plus 1 plus 2 upon x minus 2. When we simplify this, we get 5x minus 4 upon x plus 1 x minus 2. That is, vice versa of this part can also be split like this. 5x minus 4 upon x plus 1 x minus 4 can be rewritten as the sum of two partial fractions. So resolving or splitting such rational fraction of the same form is called as a resolving into partial fractions. In a rational function, we also can say it as a polynomial fraction. An expression of the form a naught x raised to n plus a1 x to the power n minus 1 plus a2 x to the power n minus 2, so on up to an, where a naught is not equals to 0. That is, first element should be non-zero numbers. And these all are called as a naught, a1, a2, so on till ar are called as constants. R to b are called as polynomial of degree. Polynomial in x of degree n. For example, first example, 3x square 3x raised to 7 minus 7x raised to 5 plus 13x cube plus 8 is a polynomial in x of degree 7. The highest degree in this equation has to be considered, so that is degree 7. Similarly, in second polynomial equation, the highest degree of x here is 4. The third polynomial equation, the highest degree here is 2. In fourth equation, x to the power 1 we have. So, it is a polynomial in x of degree 1. Next, if fx and gx are two polynomials in x, then f of x upon g of x, where g of x is not equals to 0, is called as a rational fraction or a rational function. So for example, 8x square minus 5x plus 2. So here it is in terms of x only, polynomial is in x only, that is your fx divided by 3x cube plus 4x minus 9, that is your g of x. Here g of x should not be equals to 0. If it is equals to 0, then the whole fraction will be equals to 0 only. Therefore, it should contain a non-zero polynomial function. Similarly, go to the remaining examples. These are also polynomial functions in x only of different degrees. Next one. Proper and improper rational fraction. So in our school days, we used to write a proper fraction. Proper fraction, that is, if the numerator is smaller than the denominator, then it is called as a proper function. Similarly, here also, with respect to the highest degree of x, we will distinct as proper as well as improper rational fraction. See here, a rational fraction fx upon gx is called a proper rational fraction if the degree of the numerator polynomial is less than the degree of the denominator polynomial. It is called an improper rational fraction if the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator, or sometimes it may be equal also. It is called as a improper rational fraction. For example, 3x plus 5 upon x square plus x minus 2. Here, just compare the degree of the numerator as well as the degree of the denominator. That is, degree of numerator, that is 3x plus 5 is equals to 1, and degree of denominator here is x to the power 2. The highest degree in the denominator is 2. Therefore, 1 in the numerator, 2 in the denominator, hence it is a proper rational fraction. By definition, similarly, third one, x square plus 9x plus 19 is there. In this, the highest degree is 2, and in the denominator, the degree of the polynomial x square plus 7x plus 5, the degree here is 2 only, hence they are equal in their degrees, hence it is an improper rational fraction. So with the example, let us try, we also can convert the improper rational fraction into sum of polynomial as well as a proper rational fraction. So let us see this example. Consider x square plus 1 upon x square minus 5x plus 6. It is an improper rational fraction. Divide the numerator by denominator. So when you divide like this, so what you will get? X square, first term we have to eliminate, therefore divide it by 1 only, that means multiply it by 1. X square 1's are x square minus, multiply the denominator by 1 and keep it in the next place of x square plus 1. So x square plus 1 is a dividend, x square minus 5x plus 6 is a divisor, 1 is a quotient. Then when you multiply this, what you will get? X square will get cancelled. Then 5x will become plus 5x. Why? Because we are subtracting. That minus and this minus will become plus. Therefore, you get remainder as 5x minus. So plus 6 will become minus 6 plus 1. So you will get minus 5. Minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5. Now write all these divisor, dividend, quotient and remainder as a sum of a polynomial and a proper rational fraction. That is, quotient you have to convert it, it will become a polynomial, that is 1, plus remainder you write down in the numerator, and denominator will be as your divisor. So like this, you have to convert an improper rational fraction into sum of a polynomial and a proper rational fraction. We'll see another example for practice purpose. That is, consider x cube plus 7x square plus 17x plus 11 upon x square plus 5x plus 5. So when you compare numerator with denominator, so it is a improper rational fraction. So x cube upon x cube and x square, so numerator have the highest degree than the denominator. Now the same process you follow, divide the numerator by denominator, then eliminate the first terms, x cube by x square. So you will get only by multiplying x square plus 5x plus 5, when you multiply these three elements by x only. Fine, x square into x is x cube, again 5x into x is 5x square, plus 5 into x is 5x. Now simplify this part by subtracting. X cube will get cancelled. 7 minus 5 is 2, x square. Then 17 minus 5 is plus 12x, plus take 11 down. Then again, this is a remainder, first step of the remainder. Now you can further divide it by 2 only. Divide it, then multiply the same divisor by 2, you get x square into 2 is 2x square, 5x into 2 is 10x, 5 into 2 is 10. Then after subtracting, you get 2x plus 1. Now, same way, quotient you have to write as a polynomial plus remainder you have to write in the numerator place upon divisor. So this is how you have to convert an improper rational fraction into sum of a polynomial as well as a proper rational fraction. So this is exercise number 5.1. Same type of sums they have asked you to practice. Express the following as a sum of polynomial and a proper rational fraction. So down only we have given some answers of the exercise 5.1. Do it yourself and check your answer with these answers. Okay, next part, that is a partial fraction. Rules to resolve a proper rational fraction fx upon gx into partial fractions are discussed below in two different cases. That is, in first case, denominator consists of non-repeated linear factors. That is, here C. Corresponding to each non-repeated linear factor ax plus b of the denominator g of x, consider a fraction a upon ax plus b where a is a constant to be determined. So if fraction factors in the denominator, if it is not repeated, then use this step. Otherwise, go to the second case. That is, denominator consists of repeated linear factors. If the denominator g of x consists of a linear factor ax plus b repeated r times, that is in the form of ax plus b raised to r, then consider the partial fractions as a1 upon ax plus b, a2 upon ax plus b raised to 2, a3 upon ax plus b raised to 3, and so on up to ar upon ax plus b raised to r, where a1, a2, a3, so on up to ar are constants to be determined. For example, 2x plus 3 upon x plus 1 the whole square we have into x minus 5. See, the denominator contains the factors repeated, that is x plus 1 repeated twice. Square is there, therefore it is repeated twice. So this can be further splitted into a upon x plus 1 then plus b of x plus 1 the whole square, then plus c of the next factor, that is x minus 5. That means the repeated linear factors are converted in terms of first with the first one time, then again second time x plus 1, then x plus 1 the whole square. If x plus 3 will be there, then x plus 1 raised to 3 three times, then simple, first you write down x plus 1, then x plus 1 square, then x plus 1 cube. Three times, three factors you have to split just below a, b and c. I hope students are understanding this. Then there is a remark: for an improper rational fraction, we first express it as a sum of polynomial and a proper fraction as discussed earlier, and apply the appropriate rule to the so obtained proper fraction. That means in the previous sums what we have done, no? For that also we can write the linear factors. We can resolve into partial fractions by converting it into linear. Then we have some steps. So we will do it in the next example. that is resolve x plus 8 upon 2x square minus x minus 1 into partial fractions. So here the given fraction is proper rational fraction with the denominator polynomial can be factorized into linear factors as, so first you have to convert the denominator into linear factors as, since it is a quadratic equation we get two factors only, that is x plus 1, 2x plus 1. Now the given rational fraction can be splitted into x plus 8 upon, in place of denominator you write down x minus 1, 2x plus 1. Now split into resolving, that is a upon x minus 1 plus b upon 2x plus 1. So call it as equation number 1. Now we need to find the value of a and b. These are the constants to be determined. So the first step is multiply both the sides of equation 1 by x minus 1, 2x plus 1. So we get x plus 8 is equals to a into 2x plus 1 plus b into x minus 1. So if you take LCM, if you solve, you will get second equation. Now to get the equation, to get the value of a, make b 0. To get b value, make a 0. Fine. Now see, to get the value of a, make equation b 0. The value of b is equals to 0. So how you will get? So in front of b there is x minus 1. So there is a minus 1. So to get this x value, the whole term 0, you just put value of x is equals to 1 only. Why? Because 1 minus 1 is 0. So when you substitute value of x is equals to 1, our second element, that is b, will become 0. Then we get a value automatically. Therefore put x is equals to 1 to find a, as here put x is 1, 1 plus 8 is 9, which is equals to a into 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 3, plus b times 0. Then after dividing 9 by 3, you get value of a is equals to 3. Similarly, put x value is equals to minus 1 by 2. Why minus 1 by 2? Students, just observe here, 2x plus 1 is equals to, put t is equals to 0. Then our value of x is equals to 2x is equals to minus 1, then x is equals to minus 1 by 2. If you put this value here, you get value of b. Similarly, in the first step also same thing we have done. X minus 1, we have compared it with 0. Then shift 1 that side, you get x value is equals to 1. Like that you understand, you will get easy answer. See what to substitute. Now, if you take x value minus 1 by 2, then simplify in the RHS, LHS part, that is minus 1 by 2 plus 8. That is 2 8s are 16. In 16, if you remove 1, you get 15. 15 upon 2, which is equals to a into 2 into minus 1 by 2 plus 1. 2, 2 will get cancelled, minus 1 plus 1 will become 0, plus b into x value is minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 is minus 3 by 2. Simplify these two parts, then you get 2, 2 will get cancelled, then divide 15 by minus 3, you get minus 5. So substitute a value 3 and b value as minus 5 in first equation, then we get x plus 8 upon x minus 1, 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1, which is equals to a is 3 divided by x minus 1. There is a minus 5, So plus into minus is minus. So in between the two rational fractions, you put minus sign. B upon, that is 5 upon 2x plus 1. One more example. Resolve x minus 1 upon x into x plus 2, x plus 4 into partial fractions. The given fraction is a proper fraction whose denominator has 3 non-repeated linear factors. Okay, they are not repeated once only, they have come. Therefore, split it into sum of 3 rational fractions, that is a upon x plus b upon x plus 2 plus c upon x plus 4. Call it as first equation. Then multiply equation 1 by the denominator so as to get x minus 1 is equals to, in the second part, multiply a by x into x plus 2 x plus 4. Then you will get only a into x plus 2 x plus 4. Why? Because denominator will get cancelled with the numerator term x into x. The same term will get cancelled, x and x. So remaining elements you have to write in front of a. Similarly, in front of b, x plus 2 will get cancelled with the numerator when you will multiply with the x plus 2, x plus 4. So you get b into x plus 4, x plus. Next term, c into x plus 2. If you proceed the same steps, you will get such answer. That is your second equation. Now, to find the values of a, b and c, what you have to make? To get a value, make b and c 0. So, to make this, just observe b and c part. B into x is there, c into x is there. So, if you make these two only zeros by taking x value zeros, you will get exact value of a. Now, substitute x value 0 in second equation, you get 0 minus 1, that is minus 1 only, is equals to, put x value 0, then you get a into 2 and 4 plus b into 0 of anything is 0 plus c into anything 0 of anything is 0. Then you get the value of a is equals to minus 1 upon 4 to the 8. Similarly, go to step 2, that is just see, to get the value of b, check value of a and value of c, which term is common, its opposite term you should take, that is plus 2 we have, take minus 2, x plus 2 is there, so this is a common element. So compare it with 0, you will get x is equals to minus 2. So substitute it in second equation, you get value of b. Substitute and simplify carefully, you get value of b. Similarly, in second equation, if you put x value is minus 4, you get c value. Just compare a and b. What is common here? X plus 4. Plus 4 is there, its opposite number is minus 4. So if you put minus 4 in second equation, you get c value, that is minus 5 upon 8. Now substitute all these values in equation 1, you get the required answer, that is resolving the given rational fraction into sum of partial fractions. Okay. Next, with more sums we will meet in the next class. Till then, you just practice all these sums again and again. Thank you.